Hi there, I'm Laura from Lingvess. Would you like to have fun while learning English? An amazing way to do so is through TV series. And I have many students from all over the world who often ask me, Teacher, what are the best series to improve my English? Well, today I'm gonna give you a hand with that. Now, we all know that there are many options to choose from because there are lots of series out there and many new ones are made all the time. But there are a few very important factors we should consider when picking a series to watch. One, your current English level. What level do you think you are? Are you a beginner? You know very little about English? Are you intermediate? Or are you an advanced person? How good is your English? Two, your personal preferences. Do you enjoy more watching drama? Or do you enjoy more comedy? Or maybe animation? And three, your English learning goals. What would you like to learn? Would you like to learn British English or American? Would you like to learn formal and polite expressions or would you like to learn everyday language? Well, we'll have to have a look at that. Based on these factors, we've made a list with the most fun and entertaining series to watch, which will combine different levels. I will let you know which ones are better for lower levels and which ones are better for higher levels, different topics so you will be able to choose from plenty of options and different learning goals. So you'll be able to improve your English for business, polite expressions, as well as your everyday conversation. If you think a video like this one today can be useful for you, let me know in the comments below and I'll start working on a second part so you have plenty of options to improve your English, okay? And of course, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, ring the bell for notifications, and have a look at our social media, where you will find daily content, games, and much, much more. Now, let's have a look at our top 5 series to watch to improve your English. Our first one is The Big Bang Theory.
Wait till you see this.
It's fantastic. Unbelievable.
See what?
It's a Stephen Hawking lecture from MIT in 1974.
This isn't a good time.
It's before he became a creepy computer boy.
That's great. You guys have to go.
Why?
It's just not a good time.
Leonard has a lady over.
Yeah, right, your grandmother back in town.
This is a very funny American sitcom. This is what we call situation comedy. And what makes it so unique is its characters. The whole story centers on the everyday life of Sheldon Cooper and his crazy group of friends. A very peculiar group of very nerdy physicists and scientists. It's really fun to watch, and it takes some complex scientific and philosophical theories and explains them in a very easy and interesting way. Which is amazing for your English, because you'll be learning idioms and expressions natives use all the time, and you will also be learning very high-level vocabulary, a lot of it connected to science. So if you have a high level of English, this series is for you. My second recommendation for you is The Bridgertons.
My name is Lady Whistledown. You do not know me, and never shall. But be forewarned, dear reader, I certainly know you. The social season is upon us. We shall discover which young ladies might succeed at securing a match.
Now with this one we head over to England, and this series is perfect for learners of British English, because the story centers on the aristocratic Bridgerton family, who live in a very competitive society of the Regency era in London. The reason why we include it in our list, apart from its very exciting storyline, is that it uses a classic type of English called received pronunciation, or RP, also known as the Queen's English, which is very clean, very correct, and very easy to understand. So this series is perfect for any learner of English, especially those at low levels. Series number 3 is Suits.
Find me another one.
Give each guy a hard time before you send them back. Give me a wink if they say something clever.
Okay. Excuse me, you are 5 minutes late. Is there a reason why I should let you in?
I'm just trying to ditch the cops, okay? I don't really care if you let me in or not. You want me. You want Mike Ross.
Harvey Specter, nice to meet you.
Unfortunately, we only hire from Harvard, and you haven't even gone to any law school.
What if I told you that I consume knowledge like no one you've ever met, and I've actually passed the bar?
I'd say you're full of crap.
Read me something.
Civil liability associated with agency is based on
the reasonable inference of agency on behalf of the plaintiff and the nature of the damages themselves.
How did you know that?
I like to read. Once I read something, I understand it. And once I understand it, I never forget it.
This series is fantastic for anybody who would like to learn legal vocabulary. Now, even if you are not a lawyer and you don't need to learn legal English, this series is amazing anyway because it combines comedy and drama. And the most important thing for you as a learner is that this series combines formal and polite business English and general everyday conversation. So by watching it, you'll be learning polite but also colloquial English. This one is definitely recommended if you are a learner with a higher level of English. Number 4 is The Haunting of Bly Manor.
I know what loss is. Your parents loved you so, so much. In a way, they'll always be here.
Strange, but I'm having somebody else's dream.
What dreams?
If you've ever been my student, you must know how much I like horror. And this series is just fantastic. It's about an American nanny who moves to Britain in order to mind two little orphans. And of course, they live in a huge mansion and, as expected, a lot of creepy, mysterious things start to happen. Even though the nanny is American, the children and those living with them belong to well-off British families. So you'll be learning very clear and high-class British English. The characters speak very clearly, very correctly, which makes it perfect for lower levels of English. And my last must-watch series is Once Upon a Time.
There is a town in Maine.
I'd like a room.
Welcome to Storybrooke.
Where every storybook character you've ever known is trapped between two worlds.
The evil queen sent a bunch of fairy tale characters here.
And now they don't remember who they are.
Victims of a powerful curse.
Everything you love, everything all of you love, will be taken from you.
Only one knows the truth, and only one can break her spell.
It's your destiny. You're gonna bring back the happy endings.
You enjoy your stay.
If you are into fairy tales, you'll love this one. This series, named after the typical way we start a story, Once Upon a Time, alternates two settings: a fantastical world where fairy tales happen and an American real world town. This series has lots of fantasy and adventure, so it's fun, entertaining and really easy to follow. The characters mainly speak American English, but because they belong to a fairy tale, there's not too much slang or difficult accents, okay? So there you have another great series to help improve your English. I hope you enjoyed this list of series, and I'm really curious about which one you're gonna watch first, so let me know in the comments below. And why not go and have a conversation class with me and English speakers from all over the world? That'll be a fantastic occasion to put into practice all the English you learn after watching those series. If you've enjoyed this lesson today, give it a big thumbs up and share it with anybody you think may find it useful. Don't forget to subscribe and, of course, have a look at any of these two videos if you would like to continue improving your English with us. Thanks for being with me today. I'll see you very soon, but in the meantime, practice this, enjoy it, and share it.